is pretty good. How to get the cash.
Every time.
Got a 1-1 score. Hope your audio and video is coming in better now. We did a little refresh. And everybody out there, you should refresh your browser, and stream should be coming in pretty good for you guys. Chris Byers is going to break the balls, and pretty solid player. You guys are welcome. Chris is calling the one up in the corner. Kind of like a two-way shot. Gibbs cue ball probably behind the 10. That's what he's doing. He's done well with it. Thank you. Ball in hand for Chris Byers. Got some work to do in this rack. It's called the three ball now.
Go to CTS On Demand or Bad Boys BP. Hey. They'll probably hear you anyway. Yeah.
Shot there from Chris. He's going to have a tough shot here on the seven ball. Not going to be an easy shot at all. Maybe back cutting this.
Good to see us.
Scratch, ball in hand for Dan Louie. He's gonna have three balls to run. Gotta like this, huh? He could go up 2-1 in this race to 7 over Chris Byers when he runs these out. It's 2-1. We'd like to thank sponsor of the Chinook Winds Open, the official beer sponsor, Bud Light. This is the third annual 10 Ball Championships, Chinook Winds Open. $17,000 at it, $12,000 at it to the men's, and $5,000 at it to the women's. We are at Lincoln City on the central Oregon coast. I'd like to thank the Lincoln City Visitors Bureau. And and the Western BCA Pool Players Association for having us. Dan Luis at the break up 2-1. Chris can either play safe here or run his cue ball down off the four.
Good
part. Yeah, no lower.
It's actually a nice save. He just played it. Ever so softly. Still
yeah.
Stuck behind the six.
Yeah, he might have left him a shot on a cut on the four in the corner. Might have left him a shot here.
Can he come off the rail behind the six and cut it in? Down here in the corner?
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Bottom left, he might be able to make it there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then should be able to come over for the five, too.
Yeah, you'll get shape from there. Pockets to four. Looks like Chris is going for the jump. And Dan's gonna like this. Table's open now. Natural angle to the five. Everything's laying really good for him. He can go up 3-1 if he gets out here.
Always fighting the end. That doesn't go in.
Well, 3-1 now is your score. Dan Louie leading Chris Byers. There's about 80 tables, roughly. Nice break from Chris. Doesn't make a ball.
He's gonna try and masse around the eights a little bit. He tried it. He's gonna get a Danny ball in hand. Tenney didn't like the outcome after shooting that one ball. You can see the two. You can play safe here. Come back behind the 10, I think. You just got to watch the kiss on the 7. Almost got there. Got a little bit too much of the 7, I think, on that one. But it's going to give Chris a tough shot here. I do believe Chris will probably play safe here. Try and stay behind the 6 and 5. And he did. Snuck it right up to the 6. It was a great shot. Beautiful shot by Chris. I think Miss Liz Cole should come join us in the booth and help explain this match to me. You just have to remember you're on the radio.
Glad I said that on the radio. Mm-hmm.
Well, regardless, Miss Cole, we love you. So we got Chris on the 2. Just trying to figure out the pattern here. With ball in hand, it's got a couple different options. Chris has called the combo 5-7 on this shot. And hit that perfect. Still got the angle on the 5. Squeak it by there as he put the 6 in the corner. Very good shot on the 6. And we welcome Lenny back.
Yeah, we're probably gonna be 3-2 here, huh?
Yeah, it looks like it. It was a well-played ride. A little bit of strategy, a couple ball in hands.
Cool.
Both of them played a real good, safe game. And Danny's going to give him that one.
Thanks for posting the bracket link in the chat. Makes my job a little easier.
Why you took your small break there, Mr. Lenny? We got a question in the chat room that I think is quite interesting, and honestly had some conversations today with a couple people about this question about the 9-footers. I was told that the room's just not big enough.
Oh, no, we don't have enough space. You got to have these, I mean, these 80 bar tables aren't even enough for the event, really.
Yeah, it's pretty tight when you're in between the tables shooting side to side.
Yeah, you couldn't get enough 9-footers in here to make it work. I think down the road you'll see, I mean, the casino's supposed to be putting an addition on, so that could very well...
That's what I was told today, yep. So hopefully in the future that's going to be awesome. They're going to do everything they can within their power to keep the sport growing, and that's why I love it.
Yeah, I think you'll see 9-footers in the future here. Next year or two, probably, you'll see some 9-footers. Or a 9-foot event, possibly, you know?
You know, honestly, I would like to see both. I would like to see us have the 9-footers and the 8-footers, the 7-footers together.
That would be cool.
And, you know, do two events. That way the pros can come and, you know, possibly do some one pocket in there. Which I do believe you're a fan of.
Oh, yeah, I love one pocket.
Eventually, we're going to have to play sometime.
Oh, yeah.
Playing safe.
I don't know if he got him. Might have left him a gap.
I don't think so.
Nope. From his body language, he's
a straight window.
Yeah, but what can he do with it? You know, that's the real question.
Yeah.
I just roll into
that's
it.
That's what I was thinking. Just roll into it and try and snug the cue ball right behind the four.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he could come off the. He could actually shoot this ball. One off the four, the one will go over and his cue ball just rolls down to the end rail and it might go behind the six, the one ball. But
unless behind the six?
Yeah, the one could go over behind the six ball. If it goes off the four, it's possible. But he might be looking at playing the combination, you know? I don't know what he called. Yeah, no problem. We'll see what he does here. Chris Byers, you were asking a question about his age, about Chris Byers. He's, I don't think he's even 21. I heard that he'll be 21 soon. Like, within days. Chris might be tempted to play safe here. Nothing special.
People making balls.
Yeah, people making pool balls. What are you drinking?
Jack and Diet.
Yeah. Nah, I'm good. After I get out of here, go over to the club. Have a drink over there. Wanna go have a cold one over there?
Yeah.
It's bumping in there.
Is it? That's
popping
weird.
Off.
Yeah. Breaking off.
Yeah.
That's where all the hot ladies are at. I'm sure of it. So who won the whatchamacaller?
Warren Kiemke.
He's shooting really good, isn't he?
Yep.
As usual.
Hey.
Who did he play?
We played Randy Baker in the finals.
Who's Randy Baker?
Pretty good player.
Was he famous?
Yeah. Oregon or Washington or something.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Randy Baker. I live out in the boondocks, so I don't know anybody.
Well, they're jockeying back and forth for position with the ball in hand for Dan Louis. Things are getting a lot easier.
$50 a day. It's $50 a day.
What?
For the seat.
No.
Yeah. No, I don't know. I don't think so.
In this bar in my hometown, they have a VIP area.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can pay. It's like so stupid.
Okay.
Like it's, you know, it's penalty.
Yeah.
Sure, there's a drink server going by there all the time. So. We have a bar called Krabby's,
mm-hmm,
and the Rainbow. So you get a venereal disease and
people tuning in.
I saw you had a million views.
Over a million views, yeah. I mean,
that's
total.
Cool.
Yeah, that's neat. Same way on YouTube, you know. It's kind of neat. You know, adds up over time.
I know that, like, you gotta build this stuff up. You know? It's not like, it just doesn't happen in one day.
No.
Even though you think it might.
Yeah, it doesn't.
Dude, she is awesome. She looks really good, dude.
still fine?
Yeah.
This is the last match for the night for me.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and I'm good.
Okay.
I heard Warren Campbell went for like 3,000.
That's about right. He's playing really good. Kind of surprised John Smith went for like 500. Stanley for a bunch too. 700 or something. You need an Everly to win, don't you?
Yeah.
If he wins, awesome.
Yeah. He lost his first match.
Oh, he did?
Yeah, him and Amar Kang played.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
They're buddies, too, aren't they?
Yeah, we're all cool, you know?
Yeah. Well, as buddies as you can get.
Yeah. Three to three is your score, everybody. You are watching the Chinook Winds Open. We're live from the Chinook Winds Casino Resort, Central Oregon Coast, Lincoln City. We'd like to thank the Lincoln City Visitors Bureau, and Bud Light is our sponsor, official beer sponsor of Chinook Winds Open. This is Fast Lenny on the mic with On the Rail TV.
Yeah, after a while, you've seen it all.
You can watch the best player in the world. It just gets old.
Yeah, enough hours of it, you're like, yeah.
I like when people post that, like, man, you have the greatest job. And then I look over you, like, oh.
Yeah, right.
I mean, trade places do this, I could, and then you look over and you're like, really? Dead.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Players?
Yeah. No, just anybody, really.
No, I'm actually bad with names. I'm good with faces.
Yeah.
Like, I remember people's faces, and I'll be like, hey, how's it going? I'm like, I don't know their name.
Well, last year, I remember you sitting here, and you're like, Sherry's up.
Yeah, I'll know some of the players that I've seen on here. I'll remember names of some of the players that I've seen here that have commented in their matches. Or it helps me a little bit, because I'm, you know, with them for an hour or two watching them.
Right.
So you keep saying their names over
and
over. Yeah, it helps. But I'll get stumped sometimes. Somebody, and they're like, hey, hey. And I'm like,
hey, you.
Yeah.
I said that to a girl. I should have known. But I did know.
Oh, 4-3 for Chris Byers. After he was down, I think maybe 3-1. Making a nice little comeback. Yeah, share, support, enjoy this stream. Let everybody know that we're here live streaming and they can enjoy some live free pool. Same company that makes this Ustream producer telestream. This is just specifically for Ustream. Now, Wirecast, you can do YouTube live streams, you know, so it's kind of giving you more versatility if you don't want to stream to Ustream. You can stream on your own server, you can stream to YouTube, live stream, any provider provides live streaming. So, Wirecast is, but they're the same.
You
buy the program, and then you're good. I mean, you can pay per month if you want to have, like, no ads run on your stream. It's $2,500 a month. Yeah, they're unlimited because I get so many viewers, I can't just buy, like, 100 viewer hours. Because that 100 viewer hours isn't, like,
nothing.
Well, yeah, but that's basically, if you have 100 people watching for an hour, it's 100 viewer hours.
Yeah, that's what I mean. It's like, you can rack that up in a minute.
Yeah, it's not worth it. It doesn't make sense. But people can get, like, an ad blocker for their browser and block out the commercials. Like, when you watch YouTube.
Did you hear what Apple's kind of did with the ad blocker? You keep up on the tech stuff. Steve Jobs said that he had a very good one back in the day.
Yeah.
And I guess he's going to do it by making an ad blocker in the Apple. In the Apple Fire, so we won't see any ads at all on any.
That's crazy.
so they're going to have to, everybody's going to have to figure out how to put an ad in their stuff because the ad blocker's going to this is Steve Jobs' vision to, yeah. Bear, to basically put, the, put everybody in the business.
I use Adblocker on Google Chrome. And
oh, I love it.
I love it because when I'm watching videos, I don't get any ad
events.
Yeah. You know? Except for on my phone. Like, yeah. Yeah.
This just happened. They're freaking out. Like, everybody's freaking out. It's the next new thing that Apple's coming for.
I wonder how that works.
I don't know. But, basically, just him. This is like maybe his final. He had about five big ideas before he died that were supposed to be implemented coming out. I think this is. What kind of phone do you have?
I have an HTC M8. Android. HTC M8.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
That's pretty slim.
Oh, yeah.
Oh yeah, it's got a big screen. It's bigger than mine.
Huh. Yeah, it's HTC.
How much is that one?
$200.
Yeah,
but I put a Windows user interface on it. Uh-huh. Like, you know, because I like the... Because I have had a Windows on Windows, so I like the... I just like the way it's set up.
Right.
I can have everything on
yeah,
one
like
screen.
That too.
And, you know, I mean, the apps that I use the most I have on the one screen.
Yeah.
And I can customize it, you know, put pictures,
yeah. Is that your son?
Yeah.
What's like, he shooting?
They're just target shooting.
Yeah. With what?
Oh, it's just a. I think it was a Carl Gunn.
Right.
You know, nothing crazy.
I knew it would be a 22 because you can't play 22 shots.
It's funny, I used to target shoot a 22 when I was a little kid, and I'd go in my backyard with myself and I had a brick at 28.
Yeah.
Shoot a single shot too.
Yeah.
Action.
Yeah, I have one of those.
Yeah.
Myself.
Yeah. Yeah, it's funny just to target shoot. I might
now,
shoot off 100, 200 rounds. Well, in New York.
Even in New York?
Well, I'm an hour north of New York City, so
oh, right.
nice area, wooded area. I go back in the woods, in the field,
yeah.
Behind my house. The streams there, palm, it looks nice, yeah.
I think I'd be arrested now if they saw I was going to shoot this quick to
yeah.
New York City. Yeah. Anywhere around there. Yeah, you can't even...
Chris is going to go up 5-3, it looks like, if he can get out with these last two balls. Five to three is the score. On the Rail TV would like to thank our live stream sponsors, longtime sponsor QB Custom Cues, Volturi Cue Cases, Play the Game Clothing, check them out, playthegameclothing.com, Town Break and Jump Tips, some of the best in the business, easy to jump the ball, AZ Billiards for all your pool information, the Western BCA Pool Players Association for having us back again. We love it here at the Chinook Winds Casino Resort. And the Lincoln City Travel Bureau, it's beautiful here. And Bud Light, the official beer sponsor of the Chinook Winds Open. Oh, back to the action.
I just hope one day they'll actually turn the tables for me and I can actually set up a little better.
Yeah.
It's alright. Maybe next time. But it's cool. I mean, it's consistent. I already know what to expect when
yeah.
I come here and do the same thing.
Yeah.
And everybody likes it and they're happy with it. So. Okay, cool.
Yeah, I guess if roommate doesn't
yeah.
mind,
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Thank you. kind of wish Mike Massey were here this year.
Mr. Mike Massey. Yeah, he's on a trip, thing in Ecuador. I was hanging out in Wyoming.
Yeah, I know. I saw you. Dude, he is awesome.
Yeah, he's cool. He's cool. I was playing a video of him, an old school Mike Massey video on the live stream. People enjoyed it.
I've seen that. Where he's doing the 1 hour push ups.
Yeah. Crazy, right? Yeah, he's a beast.
I like that he's like, the guy is like huge.
Yeah.
He was so, like, he watches his own videos, him. He can hit so fucking.
We're probably gonna do a DVD, it's gonna be pretty good.
What's that?
We're never gonna do a DVD.
Are you?
Well, he comes to Phoenix a lot and he told me, he's like, he's seen me in Wyoming and I'm doing this. And he's like, I said, yeah, I did some instruction with Scott Frost. He's like, yeah, I want to do not a trick shot DVD, I want to do a full instructional teaching specialty shots, shots that can apply to pools that are very shot. I said, let's do it.
That's cool.
Yeah.
He is so nice.
He's a character. And he's got such a big name. I mean, that'd probably be a better song than Power Up on it.
Everybody.
Yeah. It might sell real good. Some of the shots are supposed to be pretty good.
You know, here's the three names that everybody knows. It's like, even though he's dead, The Miz.
Yeah.
Everybody knows, like,
yeah.
My friends that don't even know anything about pools, like, they always bring up The Miz and Mike Massey. These aren't people that know a lot about pools, they know his name.
Well, Chris Byers makes this 10 ball. 6-3 now is your score. He's on the hill. Dan Louie's got the break. Dan Louie's at the table and no shot here on the one. Doesn't know what he's going to do here. Play the game. Your question in the chat is play the game sponsoring this event. No, they're sponsoring On the Rail TV, as is Town Tips, Walturi Cue Cases, and QB Custom Cues. And AZ Billiards is helping both On the Rail and the event. So we gladly mention them. Thank Tor Lowry with 0X also. Gets a good roll here. And then Dan Louie's going to come to the table and really needs to make a good hit here or he's going to be kicked over to the one loss side.
Okay, I just want to make an announcement that if anybody takes alcohol out of this room, that they're going to be kicked out. Just be aware of that. Be mindful of that too.
We're talking about you.
Well, it's in my stomach.
Then you throw yourself out a window.
I just like cut you open and just dream it out.
Oh. Chris Byers with an opportunity to close this match out. Ball in hand. Table's wide open. Tomorrow we're going to be kicking off at 10 a.m. It's going to be Allison Fisher versus Debbie Welfringer. That's 10 a.m. Pacific time. So your chance to see the best female player who's ever lived. Some will say Jean Beloukas was, but you can't take anything away from Allison Fisher. All the titles she's accumulated and real treat for you guys to see her play. The six ball and Chris is in good shape here. He's gonna probably close out this match. Just gonna pocket the eight, the nine on the side, and if he wants to come out for the corner, he can do that also. And that's what he did. He's going to have the 9 in the corner, and he can just roll this in and play the 10 next. Nice playing by Chris Byers. Shake hands, boys. Well, guys, we'll be back tomorrow, 10 a.m. Pacific time.